Dear students, last class we have taken about the area of triangle. In today's session we are going to find out the A inverse. Already we are familiar with the A inverse, how to find out by using elementary row transformation or column transformation. But the same thing we can find out with the help of formula also. That is one more method to find out the A inverse. To have that formula, first of all we should know the knowledge of minor, cofactor and adjoint. So in the today's session we'll begin with the minor of an element. So minor of an element, the name itself suggests minor. Minor means reducing. If you are having a 2x2 determinant, by deleting some row and some column you just make it as 1x1. If you are having a 3x3 determinant, by reducing it make it as 2x2. Again by reducing you just make it as 1x1. If you are having a 1x1 determinant, don't reduce, the minor of that element is 1x1 element itself. So example I'll explain. If you are having this determinant, what is the order of this determinant? It's a 2x2. Then what is a minor? Minor, as I said, that you have to make it as a reduce. The name itself suggests it's a minor. So what is a minor of 2x2? Obviously it will be a 1x1. If I am asking what is a minor of 1? This is 1. 1 is present in the determinant. Minor of 1. If I am asking what is the minor of 1 means, so wherever 1 is present, you just delete that row and that column. Where the 1 is present? Present here row and it is present in column. Then now we can tell what is the minor of 1? The minor of 1 is 5. So and similarly, if I am asking what is the minor of 3? In this determinant 3 is present. Where the 3 is present? The 3 is present in our first row, close that one, and wherever the 3 is present again, it is present in the second column also. Now we can easily tell what is the minor of 3? It is 4. So it was actually 2x2 determinant. Now by reducing we make it as a 1x1. 1x1, don't reduce, the answer itself is 1x1. Next, similarly, if I am asking minor of 4, if I am asking find out the minor of 4, what is the minor of 4? Where is 4 is present? Now we will observe. 4 is present in the second row, close that one. 4 is present in the first column also, close that also. Now what is remaining? 3. So minor of 4 is 3. So similarly, last one, minor of 5, if I am asking where the 5 is present, the 5 is present in the row and in the second column. Now what is the minor of 5? It's a 1. So like that you have to find out the minor. By looking the example we can easily define the minor of an element definition. Minor of an element aij, a suffix ij, this is the representation we already know in the matrix introduction I have given, aij corresponding first row first element, first row second element. Recall that one. Minor of an element aij is the determinant, or else of the determinant, you can, of the determinant is obtained by deleting the ith row and jth column of a suffix ij. Deleting the ith row and jth column of aij, and minor of an element is denoted by m suffix ij. It's a notation. Wherever if you are coming across m suffix ij in your textbook or else in your problems, it means it is nothing but a notation for minor. It means 2 cross 2 determinant is reduced to 1 cross 1 for that particular element. So it is by deleting the ith row and jth column. Example, if you are having A with the determinant 4, 2, 1, 3. If I am asking what is the minor of 4, according to the definition, here Aij means you now take 4. If I am asking find out the minor of 4, so according to the definition, delete the wherever 4 is present. The 4 is present in the first row, the 4 is present in the first column. Now what is the minor of 4 means it's a 3. Okay, so this is about the minor of an element and it is denoted by m. So next we will discuss about the cofactor. Why we are discussing all these concept means to have the A inverse formula. Already we are familiar with the A inverse, I said, by elementary row or column transformation. By the help of formula also we can find out the A inverse. To have that formula we should have the knowledge of minor, cofactor and adjoint. Afterwards I will give about the formula. So cofactor, one factor will be there. Co means same. The same factor we are using for all the elements. Therefore, the name they have given as cofactor. Co means same. One of the representation we will take and we are going to substitute the values. Therefore, the name they have given as cofactor and it is denoted by capital A suffix ij. It is also having the notation capital A suffix ij. So what is that one means? For example, if I am taking if this is your 3 cross 3 determinant, so if I am asking find out the cofactor of, better you take, if I am asking the cofactor of 1, so first of all wherever 1 is present, delete that row and that column. Before going to this cofactor, what is that factor they have given? Some factor we know that. According to the definition, cofactor means some factor we need. What is that factor means? It is given by A suffix ij is equal to minus 1 to the power of I plus j. This is one of the factor they have taken, mathematicians. And the same factor we are going to use for all the 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 9 elements. Therefore, they have given the name as cofactor. We are using the same formula. Therefore, they have given the name as co. Co means same. If I am asking the cofactor of 1, so cofactor of 1 means substitute 1 in this formula. Where 1 is present? Its element name is A suffix 1, 1, you know from the matrices. And what will be this position? A suffix 1, 2, where first word indicates I, second one indicates J. Substitute here, minus 1 to the power of, to find out the value of 1, where 1 is present on the position 1, 1. Add it here, 1 plus 1. The base will be the same. It's a minus 1 always. They have taken one of the factor. Minus 1. So now delete wherever 1 is present. 1 is present in the first row and it is present in the first column. What remaining? 5, 3, 2, 9. This is nothing but minor. 3 cross 3 was there, now it become 2 cross 2. Still 2 cross 2 can be made as 1 cross 1. How you can make? Again, don't delete this one. You just expand the determinant, you are going to get one value, that is nothing but 1 cross 1 value. So which is nothing but minus 1 to the power of 2. 5 9s are 45. Minus 3 2s are 6. So minus 1 to the power of 2 means it's a plus 1. 45 minus 6. It's a 39. Correct? It's a 39. So answer will be plus 39. So cofactor of 1 means how you are going to take? You have to take one of the factor, whatever the mathematicians they have given. They have given this factor, and it is same for throughout all the 9 elements. Therefore, the name they have given as cofactor. The same factor we are using, but instead of I plus j, some values we are going to take. Sometimes 1 plus 2, 2 plus 1, 3 plus 3, depend upon the position of the element we are going to take. Where 1 is present, delete that row and that column. You are going to make it as a 2 cross 2. Again, don't reduce it for 2 cross 2. Expand the 2 cross 2 determinant, it will going to become one number, and that number we are knowing nothing but it's a 1 cross 1 order, write on that one. So this is about the example I have given about the cofactor of an element. You just take the definition. Take one more for this only. If I am asking cofactor of 9, if I am asking what is the value of or cofactor of 9, 9 means you just take 9 is present in which position? It's a a11, a12, a13. Then this will be a21, a22, a23. Then this will be a31, a32 and a33. Substitute in this formula. Minus 1 to the power of 3 plus 3. It is present where? A suffix 33. You just count it. 11, 12, 13. Next, coming to the second row, 21, 22, 23. Coming to the third row, 31, 32, 33. So this will become minus 1 to the power of 3 plus 3 according to the formula. Now wherever 9 is present, delete that row and that column. It is present in third row and present in third column. Then what remaining? 1, 2, 2, 5. You have reduced the 3 cross 3 determinant to 2 cross 2. Now still further, whatever the 2 cross 2 is there, you have to expand and make it as 1 cross 1. Minus 1 to the power of 6 means it's a positive value, it's a 1. So you take this one, 5 1s are 5, minus 4. Answer will be 1. So in this way you have to find out the cofactor. Cofactor is denoted by aij and its formula is given by minus 1 to the power of I plus j. From this, one thing you observe. Always no need to write this formula. One thing you observe, what is that observation means? If I am taking here suffixes 1 plus 1, then it will become, sign will become plus 1. If I am taking a12, add 1 plus 2, then it will be, the sign will become minus. If I am taking a13, 1, 3 I said, 1 plus 3, it's a plus 1. So alternate sign you are getting, plus, minus, plus. It means, so always no need to take the formula to find out the cofactor. You just remember the sign, it will be a plus, it will be a minus, it will be a plus. Then continuation. If the plus is stop here, then what will be the sign of this? It will become minus, it will become plus, it will become minus, it will be plus, minus, plus. Okay, so instead of taking that formula always, you just remember this and it will be easy for you people. Starting with the plus, ending with the minus, sorry, starting with the plus, ending with the plus, you just take alternate sign, plus, minus, plus. In the first row, if it is stopped with the plus, then in the second row it will start with the minus. Now take down the definition. Cofactor of an element, cofactor of an element a suffix ij. This is also a suffix ij we will give. Cofactor of an element a suffix ij is denoted by capital A suffix ij. It's a notation for cofactor. Don't get confused with this and this. It is denoted by A suffix ij and is defined by A suffix ij is equal to minus 1 to the power of the suffixes you are going to add. If you are taking A 1 1, then it will be minus 1 to the power of 1 plus 1. Instead of that, I just said you to remember the sign plus minus plus, starting with the plus, end with also plus. Okay. Minus I to the power of I plus j into m suffix ij. Why I have given m suffix ij? As I said, you have to take this factor according to the definition cofactor, some factor we are taking, and reduce the wherever that aij is present, deleting first row first column, it will become minor. So you just write mij. Okay, take next one as adjoint. Directly you take adjoint of a matrix, you take it is the transpose of the cofactor matrix. It is the transpose of the cofactor matrix. This is the definition of adjoint. So we know that how to find out the cofactor. For example, generally I am taking, but not taking the verification. Example, if this is your determinant, if all the 9 elements cofactor, if you are taken, for example, cofactor of 1, you got something 8. Cofactor of 3, you got something 7. Let us assumption. Then these values you have to replace in the form of a matrix. That is, A is equal to matrix. Whatever the 1 was there, now it has become the new number. By taking that cofactor and minor, you got 8. So replace in place of 1, you got 8. Similarly, by taking the substitution, instead of 3 you got 7, 4 you got 9, so 2 you got 6, 4 you got 11, something 13, 15, 17, 19. These values you are going to get some number. That number you have to represent in the form of a matrix. Instead of 1, what you got now? 8, by the definition of cofactor and after substitution. So now what is transpose means? First of all, you have to write the cofactor matrix. You are writing cofactor matrix. Then according to the definition, how to write adjoint? Adjoint of A, it is also denoted by adj A. Adj A. It is how to take means transpose. You know the transpose from the matrix, row will become column. Second row will become second column, third row will become third column. So this is about the definition of adjoint of a matrix. So I think adjoint is not clear for you people, because I have not taken the cofactor here completely for all the 9 values. So that we will take now in the problems, whatever we are dealing, it will be clear for you people. So you just remember, adjoint of a matrix is nothing but transpose of a cofactor matrix. What is cofactor matrix means? We already know about the cofactor. Whatever the cofactors you got, you just write in form of a matrix and take its transpose. That is nothing but a adjoint of a matrix. Now, coming to the main thing here. What we are want to discuss in today's session, we want to discuss the inverse of a matrix. So we have to find out the inverse of a matrix using determinant. And what is that formula means? Inverse is denoted by A inverse, you know that. And the formula is 1 by determinant A into adjoint A. So this is one of the formula for to find out the A inverse. This formula will have the derivation, but I am not taking the derivation because derivation is not important for theory point of view. Okay. So just eliminate the proof for that and you just take only formula A inverse equal to 1 by determinant A into adjoint A. One more condition, whatever the determinant A value is there, when you expand the determinant 3 cross 3, 2 cross 2 or 1 cross 1, your value should not be equal to 0. If this type of condition is there, it is said to be a non-singular matrix. Non-singular matrix. So what is non-singular matrix? When you expand the determinant, if your determinant value is not 0, it may be negative. If it is not 0, then such a matrix is said to be a non-singular matrix. Then what is singular matrix? We can easily tell. See, this is singular matrix. When you expand the determinant, you got 0 means that matrix is said to be a singular matrix. So what is the condition for inverse of a matrix? To have the inverse of a matrix, our determinant A should not be equal to 0, or else you can tell, to have the inverse of a matrix, the matrix should be a non-singular. It is important for competitive examination. I will write here CE. To have inverse, matrix should be a non-singular, that is when you expand the determinant your value should not be equal to 0. So this is about the singular and non-singular. Once again I'll tell what is singular. When you are expanding the determinant, if your value you are getting 0, then it is said to be named something as singular matrix. If you are expanding the determinant, if your value is not equal to 0, either it may be negative also, no problem, then such a matrix is said to be a non-singular matrix. The condition to have the inverse of a matrix, it should be a which matrix? Non-singular matrix. Remember, it's important for competitive examination. So I have provided the condition. Okay, so based on this we will find out the inverse. Second, find the inverse of the following matrices. First problem, A is equal to 0. So this is your one of the matrix. Now you just remember the formula what I have given, A inverse equal to 1 by determinant A into adjoint A. I have not given the derivation because it's not important for the theory examination. But this formula also have the derivation. 1 by determinant A into adjoint A. First of all, find out determinant A. If it is not equal to 0, then only everything is possible, or else no. then we can write directly inverse not exist. Find out determinant A. So you just observe here the principal diagonal elements below that, it's a zero. Then what is the result of a determinant? It's a product of the principal diagonal by property. So when the below the principal diagonal or above it is zero, you have to take directly the product. So determinant A value will be 10. Is it 10 is equal to 0? No, it's not equal to 0. Therefore A inverse exists. Therefore, A inverse exists. According to the formula, first we have to find out it's a non-singular matrix. Now move on with the adjoint A. So to find out the adjoint A, remember you should move on with the cofactor first. Cofactor of 1 is equal to, as I said, remember the signs I said. Instead of taking that formula minus 1 to the power of I plus j, how many formulas you will remember? Because of that you remember the sign plus minus plus minus plus plus. So where 1 is present, it is present in the row and column. What remaining? 2, 4, 0, 5. So which is equal to 5 2s are 10 minus 0, which is equal to 10. It means cofactor of 1 will be 10. Similarly, cofactor of 2, its sign is minus, alternate sign, plus minus. Now delete 2 wherever present, 2 is present in the row and it is present in the second column. What remaining? 0, 4, 0, 5. Delete this one. Delete this. What remaining? 0, 4, 0, 5. So this is minus 5 into 0, 0, 0. So answer is 0. So similarly, cofactor of 3. Similarly, cofactor of 3. Where 3 is present? 3 is present in the first row and it is present in the third column. Close this one. And what is the sign here? We have taken plus, then we have taken minus, then obviously it will become plus. Plus of, delete this row and third column. What remaining? 0 to 0, 0. It's 0 minus 0, so 0. So cofactor of 3 is 0. Similarly, find out the cofactor of 0, 2, 4, still 6 elements we have to find out. Take one by one. Cofactor of 0. It's a plus, alternate sign will be minus. Now where the 0 is present, it is present in the second row, close that one, and it is also present in the first column. What remaining? 2, 3, 0, 5. It is a 5 2s are 10. So value will be minus 10. Similarly, find out cofactor of 2. We will write here. Next you write cofactor of 2. So what was the sign? Minus. Now you take plus, alternate sign, plus. Wherever 2 is present, second row it present and it is present in second column. Now what remaining? 1, 3, 0, 5. So on expansion, what you are going to get? 5 minus 0, answer is 5. Now you take cofactor of 4, sign minus. So where the 4 is present? It is present here. second row, third column. So what remaining? 1 2 0 0. Now what remaining? Still 3 elements. Find out that also. Cofactor of 0. Sign is plus. It's present in third row. Close third row and close first column. What remaining? Remaining with 2, 3, 2, 4. It's a 4 to the 8 minus 6, answer is 2. Similarly, cofactor of one more 0. Sign will be minus. So delete the third row. Now close the second column. What remaining? 1, 3, 0, 4. Answer is minus 4. Now last remaining, cofactor of 5. I'll write here. Sign will be plus. Alternate sign. See, observe. I started with plus, minus, plus. Then I have taken minus. Then I have taken plus, minus, plus. Again minus, then plus. Last. Alternate sign you just move. And close that row and that column where it is present. It's easy. First problem you will get difficult, but afterwards you just have the practice, it will be easy for you people. So cofactor of 5, delete third row, third column, it will be remained as 1 2 0 2. So this is about the cofactor. Now you have to write the cofactor matrix. Cofactor matrix is equal to what you got? Cofactor of 1 you got as 10. Replace first row will become 10, then it will 0, then it will be a 0. Next second row you will become, it's a minus, it will become, sorry, second row it will become minus 10, then it's a 5, then it's a 0. Third row it will become 2, then it's a minus 4, there it was a plus 2. This is cofactor matrix. Now according to the formula, we have to take adjoint. Adjoint of A. Adjoint of A means you have to take transpose. This first row will become first column. Second row will become second column. Third row will become third column. Now substitute in A inverse formula. Determinant A value you got 10. Adjoint A you got this one. Now it's a matrix. You know that 1 by 10 is a scalar. Whenever the matrix outside is a scalar means you can multiply that scalar inside of the matrix. Then it will be 10 by 10, 1, 10 by 10, minus 1, 2 by 10, 1 by 5, it's a 0, it's a 1 by 2, 5 1s are 5 2s are, it's 2 2s are 2 5s are, minus 2 by 5, 0, 0, 1 by 5. So this is the A inverse for the given question. So is it this question, or sorry, is this inverse is correct or not? You can verify. How you can verify? You can verification with the help of A into A inverse value. This value already given. This value you got. Multiply these two. You have to get 100 010 001. Verification, how you have to do? A into A inverse. Already A value is present. Now you got A inverse. Multiply those two. You have to get 100 010 001, which is the definition of inverse, which is I. Therefore, this is the verification step to find out the inverse. It's easy. In the next class, again, I'll take with the inverse. And in today's session, I have taken about the 3 cross 3 because 2 cross 2, we are already familiar from the elementary row or column transformation. With 2 cross 2 also find out with the help of formula. That afterwards I'll take. First, we will move on with the 3 cross 3. Okay, because we have not seen 3 cross 3 in elementary row and column transformation. Okay, verification will be A into A inverse. So, the same formula I will use in the next session and we will find out still 2 to 3 problems about the A inverse so that the concept will be clear. Okay, thank you.